I am actually a good driver. Although I passed the fourth time and it was a day before my theory expired, I am actually a really good driver. I swear. I know I'm like smiling and stuff, but I swear I am a good driver. Okay, I made a few mistakes on the last time I took the test, the fourth time, which I passed. But I was telling her, like, I've got dates to go on, and I can't be going on dates in a bus. So, I think she felt sorry for me. She was like, yeah, you made a couple mistakes, but, you know, you obviously care about this girl you want to go on a date with, so I'm going to pass you. That relationship didn't work out, by the way. But I'm going to go get some Nando's. I've got some really bad news, and it's heartbreaking. I just don't know how to tell you. I think I might need to sit down for this. Earlier on today, just a few moments ago, I realized I just sprayed my last spray of Tom Ford Black Orchid. And the shops are closed, man.
Just scoop it out.
Why? Why, man? Why? I'm here at my hometown club, David Lloyd, and one of my best mates has just showed up. How long has it been? Two days? Two days?
A couple of days. Hi, people.
Do you want to let them know your Instagram?
So I'm into photography. If you want to check it out, at Chevers, Chevers. Check it out, let me know what you think.
I'll drop it in the link.
Oh yeah, perfect. This is the guy. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, smash it.
Do you skateboard?
I attempt to skateboard.
I've seen Chev on Snap and you can skateboard. Like, I attempt to skateboard. I fall off pretty much every time. But.
You're so shit.
You think you could coach me?
We can try, we can do a video on it.
You know what? Skateboarding vlog. Skateboarding vlog.
2018, coming soon. Hit that like button.
Hyperventilating, drunk laps, running around the globe. Wild goose chasing after 3 number 1 albums. Would've thought I feel amazing, still impatient, still sipping no liquor, still rolling up swishers. Nas Beamers, double pocket, fuck pen and meter. In your club, on your couch, just got paid to be it. On your girl, rubbing on my favorite features. I said that Jesus only wanted Ben Franklin's and Mona Lisa. Man, I might fuck around, lose my mind. I got a breakout, I'm on a stakeout. On the farm or your lake house. Around 3 a.m, dog, I was getting busy in the bathroom stall. Bad mama seat the Miami heater. Put it in a two-seater, too bad I couldn't three-peat her. Need a whole lot of Vita before I see the Reaper. House full of snow bunnies, putting trees up like it's Christmas Easter. Need more stamps than this skinny nigga, got tax on my visa. I know the kids in the family, they don't trust, they believe it. I mean
Jesus, 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 Jesus.
I might fuck around, lose my mind. I got a breakout, I'm on a stakeout. On a farm or your lake house.
Jesus, Jesus,
I mean
Jesus, Jesus.
man. I might fuck around, lose my mind. I got a breakout, I'm on a stakeout. On a farm or your lake house. Juice. I might fuck around, lose my mind.
What an incredible workout that was today. Trained with Stuart. He actually did shoulders first. I did back, biceps, traps. But then we decided to do arms together and added camera to it. You know, over the last couple of weeks, Friday has almost turned into cheat day or cheat night. And I've had pizza the last 2 weeks. And I'm really not feeling like it at all today. So I don't know what the heck I'm going to order. I only get one opportunity every week to cheat on my diet, so I better make it count. Cheat night Fridays and I'm with Humps. We're at Chew Burger. We've just ordered a man versus food burger times two. Your quads are just gonna soak this up.
They're gonna soak this up and I'm gonna wake up like Ronnie Coleman.
I'm gonna wake up fat. I'm just kidding. I'm training 7 days a week, so cheat meal Fridays are amazing. Guys, check out this amazing feast. Look how huge this burger is. How's the dessert?
I love the ice cream.
Look how much mess I've made.
And when you give us forks that look like fucking toothpicks.
I've been asked to do a get to know me tag and I've got so many more new viewers lately because I've been posting on various social media platforms. I never used to post on Insta, Facebook, Snapchat, but I share it across all platforms now. So I've been asked to do a get to know me tag. It's just 25 questions and it gives everyone a chance to understand me a little bit better. So let's get started. My middle name's Lincoln. What else? Share your favorite subject in high school. Okay, so my favorite subject was art, without a doubt. I just love being creative and I still do. If anything, like, my love for art in school inspired me to probably design this top. Put zips at the side. My favorite drink is definitely pre-workout at the moment, but if I had to choose one thing for the rest of my life, it'd have to be water. What is my favorite song at the moment? My favorite song at the moment is Only For Me by Chris Brown off the new album Heartbreak on a Full Moon. That album is so dope. It is so incredible. 45 tracks on one album. What would you name your children? I'd actually name a child Diesel Hader because everything I wear seems to be Diesel. Even my bag is Diesel. Like, even my camera case is Diesel. So yeah, I'd name a child after a designer fashion brand. Sorry, kids. I don't know. I'm not planning on having kids for a long time, but yeah. Diesel hater. Have I participated in any sports? Yes, I have. I used to do a lot of MMA. I used to compete in Greco-Roman wrestling. This is awfully odd. Some guy is just... he's just creeping behind me. This get to know me tag has just turned into a sibling tag. Who's the oldest and youngest?
Before we tell them, people that are new, have a quick guess, innit?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
3, 2, 1, I'm the youngest.
What was the last text you sent each other? Ooh, that's such a good one.
Do you want to check it?
Yeah, I'll have a look.
This is going to be funny. Laughing my ass off.
Yeah, that was the last text.
We won't read what we said.
We won't read what we said.
It's a bit awkward.
It's very awkward.
It's not YouTube sensitive. I mean, YouTube.
You'll get flagged. It won't really, would it?
No. It just caused
chaos. What do you like and hate about your siblings? What I like about my brother is he's very caring. But you're just a great brother, bro.
I'll be honest, I love my brother, yeah. He's wicked, innit? And he's really caring, he's generous. But one thing that annoys me...
Oh, God.
I just have to say...
Oh, man.
Sometimes I'll speak to him and I'll be on his phone. Ask me a question.
So, how was your workout? I do not do that.
It was good. You do that sometimes.
You know,
he does that so much.
No, but you know,
he does that so
okay,
much.
Okay.
I'll ask him a question, and you know what? It's not even one question. I'll do about 2 or 3 after, and he'll be like...
Okay.
And then I'll ask him a question, and look at me like this. Yeah.
Okay, my turn now. What I dislike about you is, like, when I'm talking sometimes, my brother will pretend he's listening, but then
I do listen, though.
No, no.
Because you tested me on this, like, and I knew what you asked me.
90% of the time he listens, but, like, we're in... the line waiting for food, and I was like, why don't you get more than that, like, I'll treat you.
Yeah.
And I asked you something like, are you gonna get any more? So it's a yes or no answer, and my brother was like, really? So you blatantly were listening. All right. What do you and your siblings have in common? We love training.
We've got a good sense of humor, both of us.
We are grown ass kids.
Yeah, we both have a good sense of humour.
Yeah.
We both love food, beer.
Yeah.
We both have a soft spot for food, 100%.
We do, man.
Yeah,
we just love food. And it's also, it's a strange relationship because we love fitness, but we also love food.
But we're doing well, though, I think.
We do great.
We're on our way.
We found a pattern where we can, like, progress, but also enjoy food.
Even though we've always loved food, we've always continually made progress in the gym. If we weren't getting leaner, we were getting stronger and building muscle, or our bodies were getting better somehow.
What's your funniest memory? You go first, or I'll go first.
You go first.
My funniest memory of you, I don't know if I'm allowed to share it. In the swimming pool.
No, don't.
Go, please.
No.
Please, bro. No. Let me share it. I have to ask permission for my brother to share this. It's the swimming pool incident.
When I was 4, innit?
Yeah. Can I share it?
Yeah, go
on. So basically, we're at the leisure center at the pool, and we noticed something strange at the bottom of the pool. And my dad had goggles on, and he's like, he gets under the water and he's like, what the heck is that? And someone had shit in the pool. And
it wasn't me. What is my funniest moment of you?
It could be.
The funniest moment my brother's ever, like, the funniest moment ever. My brother was once carrying a baby. This baby was a new.
Oh my god.
This baby was a newborn baby. Bear in mind, everyone was, like, fascinated by this baby. You know, when a new baby's born, they're like, oh, so cute. And then my brother picks up the baby.
No, listen.
My brother picks up the baby. Everyone's sitting there. My brother looks there and drops the baby on the head. The baby dropped on the head.
So basically, the baby was 1.5 years old, and she's sitting in my lap, and she wanted a toy. So, bear in mind, I was like 12 at the time. So I reached on the floor to get the toy, and she leans back, yeah. And she just falls straight back onto the floor. Oh man, and you know, what's crazy is her siblings just burst out laughing straight away. Luckily, it wasn't too bad. I hope you've enjoyed this vlog. Please give it a thumbs up. Click subscribe to keep updated every week. And also, like, if you could share the video, I'd be so grateful. Hope you have an amazing week. Crush all your goals. And until next time, peace and love.